I mean, from our perspective as a Muslim, I think what is wrong with Western modernity, modern means new. In modernization and modernism as a philosophy of thought, they discuss that a little from the past is too much. Some of them give you a little bit chance and say a little from the past is sometimes necessary as a flavor. Just to say that, yes, civilization, history, we need to have some elements of the history to not feel nostalgic in the modern environment. But modernism, don't forget that, especially in the terms of American modernism. You look at the Mead as one of the anthropologists, which when she discussed about the American civilization, she discussed that American civilization belongs to those who want to live today and future. American civilization does not belong to those who want to live in the past. So past is, they have a rejectionism to the past. And one of the past eternal issue is Allah, is God. So it is a metaphysic issue. So what is wrong with modernity and modernism in terms of philosophy is they reject these idea of being. According to that, I want to say that there is another ideological issue in modernism, which we have a lots of problem with that. And when we talk about academic imperialism, we should discuss it in a platform of Eurocentrism and Americocentrism. That is what is wrong, and many scholars around the world try to criticize Eurocentrism and Americocentrism. The soon you have this centrism, revenge culture is there, war is there, rejection of others is there, being deaf about other values is there. What is consequence of this wrong policy on Islam and Muslim representation in the Western academia? First, I want to say that wrong picture of Islam and Muslims dominated by demonization and assimilation policy, especially for the last 10 years. After September 11th, this trend becomes very accelerated. We have two words you need to make connection between these two words. One is representation in English, and another is representation. Representation is when you represent the reality in the form of picture, in the form of film, in the form of writing of a journalist. This is representation of the reality. Sometimes representation is very strong in a way that one becomes equal to all and all become equal to one. And Afghanistan and today Iran, this is because of this equation of one is equal to all and all is equal to one. This is very dangerous phenomena. I remember after the September 11th, just within 2 days in Britain, they attacked 350 mosques. Why? They are not rational. They are not civilized. They should attack to the Muslim in the British society because of what happened in Afghanistan and what happened in United States. Are they civilized? This is really civility? I don't believe it. This is the power of media. Media try to make equation between one and all. And they know what to do. You look at the documentary of Akbar Ahmed, Islam in the World, which supported by BBC. He come to Iran, he go to Kurdistan, and he showed Daravish in Kurdistan who put the knife in the face, and he put the subtitle Islam in Iran. Is it Islam in Iran? 95% of the Westerner, when they come for the first time to Iran, according to the UNESCO research, they have a fear. I'm sure some of our friends who come for the first time to Iran, they experience this fear because of lots of Negative representation. This is the work of representation. There is a difference between media representation and academia representation. Media representation is very sensitive, is very influential, but it doesn't work in the long term. But academic representation is very institutionalized representation, is demonized from the deep. We are in the structure of the Western culture. Everywhere. You look at this building. Is it Iranian? You look at your chair. Is it Iranian? You look at the table. Is it Iranian? No, we are there. We're living there. It is everywhere. I remember once I had a presentation in University of Potsdam. I told to my friends, scholars in the Potsdam University, what do you think? If I talk about Islamic, please notice this point. I said, what do you think if I say Islamic republicization of Germany? They said, no. We don't want it. I said, when you say democratization of Iran, this has the same connotation. This has the same meaning. But you hide the ideology of the democracy. But you say the word. You say the system. You want to implement it in our culture. We have a different history. We have a different religion. We have a different culture. Those who understand what intercultural communication means, they know that exchange position means once I have to sit in your position, and another time you have to sit in my position to have a mutual understanding. Is it? Okay, 5 minutes. We did a very important research. I think it is very important research because we try to review the about 7,600 items, including books, PhD dissertation, and article about Islam and Muslims. We try to find the typology of this production. What typology we have there? 42% of these items were books. 19% were academic papers, and 39% was PhD papers, which I'm sure many of these PhD has been researched by the Muslims, but in the Western system. You look at the trend. You look at the trend. In between 1949 to 1959, we have only 2% of these items which we research on the catalog of the Congress Library, London School of Economics, Soas University, Ingenta, which was at the time very comprehensive database of papers. So it is very comprehensive. 2% belong to the 1949 to 1959. Another 2% belong to 1960 to 69. Another 15% to 1970 to 79. Another 25%, I missed 16%. Anyway, I want to discuss about 1990 to 2009. Yes. In this period, we have about 75% of whole this production is there. Why is that so? I believe Islamic revolution of Iran affect the West in very wide manner. Esposito was used to say that when Islamic revolution got the victory, nobody was asking about Islam. We did not have any demand in academic places anywhere in the world. But now Esposito get the best salary in the United States. Because there is a serious demand about Islam. And why is that so? I believe Islamic revolution was one of the important reasons which create this importance and attention the issue about Islam. This is the model that we discuss. I'm sure all of you heard about Islamophobia. And we think that the production about Islam is only from Islamophobic perspective. No. Only 11% of whole of this production is Islamophobic. But 70% is Islamoromic. You never heard about Islamoromic. This is the concept that we created about the production which is discussing about Islam. I come to it. My time is finished, yeah?
You have 1 minute more.
1 minute
more. Well, you can take 2 minutes.
Okay, very generous, thank you. Okay, and we have Islamoverita. Islamoverita is when they try to understand the truth of Islam. When they try to go in deep to what Islam says in reality. Islamoromia is an approach which try to look at Islam from civil society perspective. Look at Islam from democratic perspective. Look at Islam from liberal perspective. This doesn't work. In terms of methodology, it is wrong. You cannot understand a society with the theory of the Western society. That is what we have problem, and what my friend said about indigenous human sciences. Indigenous human sciences means that you cannot go by the paradigm and theory of the Western culture, politics, and economy to understand the Iranian society. I recently saw a paper which tried to understand hijab by the theory of Wittgenstein. It doesn't work. You have to impose it. Almost 77% of the production about Islam is about modern issue, is a modernist approach to Islam. Only 1% is it belong to the postmodern, and 22% is belong to the is right, sorry. 22% is a sort of traditional approach to Islam, and 1% is postmodern approach to Islam. My final word, leave it for later on. This is my final word. I think no West, no East, but actual entity of Islam and actual reality of Muslim society should be readed. We cannot understand the issues. I mean, only 2% of this production is neutral. Baba, think. They still tell you that you should be neutral as an academic. Who is neutral in this world? Who can be neutral in this world? They have ideology of understanding. They cannot leave the ideology. They look at the things by ideology. Doesn't matter they are Marxist or they are liberalist. They cannot escape themselves from their tools of understanding. So the right way of understanding is exchange position understanding. Sit in the position of the Islam. Sit in the position of Muslims to understand the whole reality. Thank you.